वेलकम एवरीवन। वी आर डिस्कसिंग एमसीक्यू प्रॉब्लम ऑफ मैट्रिसेस। सो लिसन थ्रू दिस वीडियो टुडे आई विल डिस्कस एमसीक्यू प्रॉब्लम रिलेटिंग डेफिनेशन ऑफ मैट्रिसेस एंड ऑपरेशंस ऑफ मैट्रिसेस। Relating definitions and operations of matrices. At first, relating definitions of matrices. So, you know, square matrix. So, square matrix. I have already discussed this square matrix n into n. Number of rows equals to number of columns. Now diagonal matrix we will consider only third order matrix. So diagonal row d1 0 0 0 d2 0 0 0 So this is diagonal matrix. Non-diagonal elements are not zero. Non-diagonals are zero. It is also represented by DIAZ, D1, D2, D3. This is diagonal elements. Diagonal matrix. And you know, if D1, D2, D3 are same, suppose all are A, then it is scalar matrix. So diagonal matrix. Then scalar matrix. All the diagonal elements are same and identity matrix. All of you know it. Identity matrix. So they are. So diagonal matrix, scalar matrix, and identity matrix. Then upper triangular matrix. It is diagonal matrix. So suppose this one is A1, A1, A1. A22, A23, A33, and this is 0, this is 0, this is 0. Upper triangular matrix. So this is diagonal elements. So below diagonal elements, these elements are 0. This is upper triangular matrix. So it is square matrix whose elements below diagonal are all 0. So this is definition. But we can write it in this way. Look, it is A21. A21 equals to 0. This is A31 equals to 0. A32 equals to 0. That is Aij equals to 0 for I greater than 0. So Aij equals to 0 for I greater than j. So look, A12 is not 0, A21 0, A31 0, A32 0. So Aij equals to 0 for I greater than j. So this is upper triangular. So look, a matrix A, problem number 4, is said to be upper triangular if A is square, obviously A is square, and Aij equals to 0 for I less than j, and Ai square matrix Aij equals to 0, I greater than j. So option 2 is correct. For upper triangular or lower triangular, so matrix must be square matrix. So E is not square, it is not possible. So option 2 is correct. A I j is said to be upper triangular. What is the definition? A I j equals to 0 for I greater than j. This is upper triangular. And what is lower triangular? Lower triangular. So opposite to it. So this is A21, A31, A32, and this is 0, this is 0, lower triangular. So elements above diagonal are all 0. Look, here it is A12 equals to 0, A13 equals to 0, A12, A13, A23 equals to 0. Therefore, Aij equals to 0 for I less than j. So look, Aij equals to 0 for I less than 0 and A is square matrix, then it will be lower triangular matrix. Lower triangular matrix. So it is given in this form, problem number 4, and if we consider it is lower triangular, then 4-1 is correct option. This one. So Aij. So you write A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23. Then it will be simple. A12 0. So Aij 0. I less than j. Next, regarding definition. Orthogonal matrix. Orthogonal matrix. What is definition? You know, a square matrix A is said to be orthogonal if A into A transpose equals to identity matrix. Identity matrix. So A is square matrix such that A into A transpose equals to I. Then A is what? A is orthogonal. So option C is correct. So this is definition of orthogonal. So only definition is sufficient. Now number 2. A is orthogonal matrix, then A inverse equals to what? A is orthogonal. So A is orthogonal. So A into A transpose equals to I. So we know if AB equals to I, AB equals to BA equals to I. So we write B equals to A inverse. So this is definition of inverse. If product of two square matrices is I, then one is inverse of the other. Now look, A into A transpose equals to I. So here it is B. So what is B? B equals to A inverse. So what is B? A transpose equals to A inverse. So look, A is orthogonal matrix, then what is A inverse? A inverse equals to A transpose. So very simple, A inverse equals to A transpose. Now, this is most important, A is orthogonal matrix, then determinant A equals to what? A is orthogonal. So we have already considered this I. Now if we take determinant A transpose, this is I, then determinant. Taking determinant on both sides. Now we know determinant of AB, determinant A into determinant B. And determinant of unit matrix is 1. I equals to 1, 0, 0, 1. For second order, this is 1. For third order, it is also 1. Now, we know A transpose is matrix obtained by changing rows into columns. There is an important property of determinant that if we change rows into columns, then value of determinant is not changed. So A transpose is changing rows into columns, then determinant. So A, determinant A equals to determinant A times 4 from property of determinant. So, putting value determinant A into determinant A, A times 4 equals to this, equals to 1. So, determinant A square equals to 1, A equals to plus minus, determinant A equals to plus minus 1. So, this one is correct option. Now, inverse of diagonal matrix is what?
Inverse.
So, for example, we take a diagonal matrix G1, 0, 0, 0, second order. So, what is determinant A? Equals to D1, D2. So, A inverse equals to adjoint of A by determinant A.
You know?
And what is adjoint of A? For second order, transpose of cofactor matrix D1. So, this is D2, 0, this is 0 with negative. This 0, this is 0, and D2 is D1. Then transpose. So, D2, 0, D2, D2, 0, 0, D1. So, minus 0, this is 0. So, shortcut method to find adjoint, interchange these two and you take negative of this one and negative of this one. So, what is A inverse? A inverse equals to 1 by D1, D2. D2, 0, 0, D1. So, if you divide by D1, D2, you know for matrices, you have to divide each element by D1, D2. So, this is 1 by D1, 0, 0, 1 by D2. So, what is inverse? Inverse is also diagonal matrix. Inverse of diagonal matrix is also diagonal matrix. So, or you can write, what is the property? Diagonal D1, D2. If you take inverse, then diagonal 1 by D1, 1 by inverse of diagonal. So, this is important result. Now, we will consider some MCQ problem regarding operations of matrices. That is sum of matrices, product of matrices. Next, operations of matrices. So, we know sum of matrices, A and B are two matrices. Aij, M cross N. B equals to Aij, M cross N. A plus B is possible if they are of same order. So, sum of matrices is possible if they are of same order. Same order. And product A equals to Aij, M into B equals to Bij, N into P. AB is possible if N equals to B. Number of columns of A equals to number of rows of B. So, using these two definitions, we can solve problem number 1, 2 and Now look, problem number 1. A is a matrix of order M into N such that AB and BA are both defined. So A equals to Aij, m into n. This is given. So since AB is positive, so what is B? Equals to BIZ. So n cross B. AB is possible. So number of columns of A equals to number of rows of B. So AB is possible. So order of B should be n cross B. Now B A is possible. B A. So what is B A? B I Z into n cross B. A I Z into n cross B. Now B A is possible. B A is possible if P equals to number of columns of B, P equals to M. So P equals to M. So A is a matrix of order, then A B and B A are both defined. Then what is order of B? So what is order of B? B equals to B I Z. B I Z. So N, what is P? P is M. P is M. N cross M. N cross M. Because P equals to M. So this is answer is B. So unit idea of product of two matrices. Now problem number 2. So this and this is possible. So what is the order of the final matrix? So XYZ, this is called row matrix, 3 into 1. And this is 3 into 3. And this is column matrix. So 1, this is 1 row, 3 column. So 1 row, so 1 into 3. First row, third column. This is 3 into 3 and this is 3 into 1. Now, if product of first and second is possible, then number of columns of A equals to number of rows. So, they are same. So, if you apply first matrix and second matrix, so what will be the order? 1 into 3. So, if you apply this, so 3, 3 is absorbed, 1 into 3. And this is 3 into 1. Again, number of columns equals to number of rows. So this is absorbed. So this is 1 into 1. So 1 into 1. So final is 1 into 1. Final matrix is of order 1 into 1. Number of columns of A equals to number of rows of A. So AB is possible. So this is absorbed 1 into 3. Then 3, 3 absorbed 1 into 1. And number 3. A and B are matrices such that A plus B and AB are both possible. Then which option is correct? A and B are two matrices. A plus B is possible. So A equals to AIJ, M into N. B equals to BIJ, M into N. Because A plus B is possible. A plus B is possible. So A and B are of same order. Now AB is possible. AB. So this is M cross N. And this is also M cross N. So AB is possible is number of columns of A. So N equals to number of rows of B. So B, N equals to M. N equals to M. So what is A? A equals to AIJ, N cross N. What is B? BIJ, N cross N. So look at the final answer. A and B are square matrices of same order. So A and B are square matrices of same order. So option C is
correct. Very simple problem using definition of operations sum of two matrices and product of two matrices.
Finally, very simple problem, problem number 4. 2 into this plus this 7, 6, 15, 14. Find x and y. So, scalar multiplication, operations of matrix. You have to multiply each element by 2. 2x 10. So, 14, 2y minus 6. 3 minus 4, 1. 7, 6, 15, 14. Now, sum of two matrices, 2x plus 3, 10 minus 4, this is 6, 14 plus 1, 15, and this is 2y minus 6 plus 2, so 2y minus 4. So, 7, 6, 15, 14.
So, from equality of two matrices,
look. 2x plus 3 equals to 7. 2x plus 3 equals to 7. So 2x equals to 4, x equals to 2. 6 equals to 6. So this is okay because a12 equals to a1. 15 equals to 15. Okay. So 2y minus 4 equals to 14. So 2y equals to 18. So what is y? Y equals to 9. So options would be 2, 9, B, minus 2, 9, C, 9, 2, D, minus 9, 2. So, option is 2, 9.
So, today, through this video, we have discussed some simple and important problem of MCQ of board exam.
Relative definitions, operations of matrices.
I will take one more class regarding to find adjoint and inverse of matrix. So, thank you for today.